the final part. Down there was actually a mythical brick. You didn't use my sword to destroy it. And fast interactions was right there. You need the whistle sword and turn it in. It's 25,000 for it. That's all you need to know. What I didn't know it cut off. So it is right there. So it's like, I wasn't like trying to make it like, okay, so three. And I was hoping it was done, this part. So here's our next one right here. So our final one we're going to be able to, we're doing, then we're finally doing Mount Doom. That level starts, I mean, we have to just travel for a minute to be able to do this one, because I am, like, happy that we're almost done, because Mount Doom is probably, like, the one of the quick levels I would actually put it as, because Frodo's and Frodo and Sam level, like, the main first five, weren't as, like, the first two, like, the only long level, they were, like, medium-sized levels, all of them, except for Mount Doom. I refer it as a very, as a short level. Because, one, it's the final level in the game, obvious. So, we actually will flip to him, by the way. If you try to climb Mount Doom as my character, our characters, it will actually trigger the level Mount Doom. So, you cannot climb Mount Doom. This is the last thing I'm doing, and this is the last open world thing I have to do in between story before we're just going to be done. That was it. Okay, now for real, we're doing Mount Doom. Here's Mount Doom. Okay, so there's more. Like, so we're almost done. Like, sorry it's been, like, a long part. Like, so you've noticed I tried to jump as Frodo. I cannot jump as Frodo. By the way, I did turn on Action Assistant. They refer it as, but it's actually Fast Interactions. So we're gonna actually, Mount Doom is only like 10 minutes. So Mount Doom will not even take us long. So, what I don't like, what I probably don't like about Mount Doom is, like, seriously, that, one of the things I will explain right after, we hit that point, is probably what I didn't like about Mount Doom was this is the whole level. It's where it was actually, you are playing as Sam for most of the level. I just gotta check. Hang on a minute. So, I think, a reason I didn't like Mount Doom was just because of this. Like, Sam is the only one who can jump in the level. Frodo sadly has to walk across like that. Because it makes sense. He's actually wearing down. And it's like, this is probably one of those levels that I was pretty shocked about, that they actually, it looks like they didn't even have to code that much to make it similar to the first level. You know, you hate when the litter has to do it for you. Yep. Been there. There'll be a certain pile we have to break that would be for, something, but it's not right now. By the way, there's supposed to be lava there, but, I guess they didn't even code it right. Yeah, so it's free. So, by the way, our last main kit comes towards the end, so you need to do. It's like, we'll be up there soon. You need to actually drop. So yeah, I basically had to say this level is like too quick. Like how you can play as Frodo and jump. This should trigger the next scene. So, this is like the only thing you can do in the level. There's one more minikit there. That's not the last one. I think my con about this level is, so you will drop right here. I don't remember if you have to do it a second. I know you have to do it a second time, but I don't know if you have to do it a third time. I think you have to do it a third time. I wish you really can hit it off of Frodo, like right now. And of course, the same thing happened to Zeos, like, hey, the ring is mine, and that. I kind of like that you cannot, another nice thing that I know is that this would be the point where Gollum real doesn't fall for the same trick. No, it's only a second time, that's it. So, on your second time, you'll notice this. But this is only for free play, so we'll have to worry about it again. You pull this. You'll actually notice this drink pad. The fun fact is, I want to talk about it. It used to be that you only can do this as Sam, because you could have flipped to any other character in your pack, but then, so that's why you needed the boxing gloves in that, but then they updated at one point where you could have done that, but then they changed it back, so you're forced to play as Sam. If I had to say this, this is probably like one of the best level boss fights. In the movie, he actually bites off his finger. Frodo's finger. Just saying it out there. Before he gets actually shoved into the fire. Actually, you know what doesn't make sense? Why they have this particular part when he should have died on impact of lava. And I like how the tower gets destroyed and falls over, even though Ferritorga and the eye should have first got disintegrated, and then the tower could start falling over. It actually doesn't explain the movie, but that movie, I did remember the ending of the movie because I didn't actually see that actual full ending. In the ending of the movie, they actually, this is the last part of the level, so, you literally get to sit here and do that because that's the only minicay here. It's so weird that they even have a gateway to the mountain, even though it shouldn't be a gateway. Oh wait, because that's his private forge. There's a forge that every orc can use, except for the volcano. The volcano is his private forge. So this is the last level.
yet. Now I can officially say that I think this. I guess they're miniature. I don't know.
Right. So. Well, they don't talk about it. There's an Elva and Port part where, Frodo and Bilbo go to the... So Frodo gets done writing The Lord of the Rings. That was the last thing. They go to the Elven Port because they go on this boat because technically they're not man no more, so they can't be on this earth. So that's why they go to the boat. It's not really explained what happens. But... that's all I'm just gonna have to say. So technically, I'm gonna actually, before I start free play for Mount Doom, I'm actually gonna change the location tonight. It might take off the horseshoes, but yeah. So I could just get the nighttime brick done here. So I could skip the fields. By the way, the new objective would be pointing towards you to the bonus level. But another interesting thing I can warm you in this game was actually you were supposed to attack and then buy him. They actually updated the game so you didn't have to do that. And also another requirement that used to be was also ahead of a day. But of course you see that also changed. So the reason you had to do this one had to be done at night, because you couldn't actually approach this area, because it would trigger the level no matter case, what side, no matter case. So, we got that. Now, we're actually going to do Mount Doom. So, congratulations, that is one area off the list. So, obvious. We don't actually have to do this whole level proper. So that's our first mini kit. And then on the side over here, would actually be this. This is our first duel. Don't be mistaken. I found it so funny that all the tools except for one, you have to use it from this level. There's the trophy shield. Story events, but you actually all the tools except for one is on the last tool is at the last scene, but you get all the minikits here, so that's the bonus. Dang it. I did that wrong. I was at it. I should have just went to the otter ledge, like, not jump for it like that. I should have went on the ledge like that and then do it. Oh, I can make a joke. Hey, goodness, right up, you want to amputate your hand. But, yeah. That was a funny thing, is this is like the last time you use an axe. That's it. Next one. This is like the super quickest guide I'm doing. Next tool is just right here. Yep. So now that's it. So now you get to the final part. All I'm gonna have to do is two parts. A fine golem. That's it. Two parts. That's it. So once you're here, you can't flip your characters, so, but now at this point, I personally believe they should let you access the troll bag at this point anyways. Because knowing that you won't be able to flip your character, but no, that's it. We got finished Mount Doom. So this is the part anyways, so. Even though the level shouldn't be really a level, they just decided not to. So it's still night. I'm gonna leave it night. We're gonna actually do something different from my original playthrough. We're actually going to complete this area first, so we can actually skip to, you know, it's so weird because of all those things we did. We actually could skip to Moria right after Rivendell, past the canyon. We'll do past the canyon, actually, very quick after. Come find some more. Zach, no, Blackgate and Moria. Yeah, let's add the flicker character anyways. So yeah, there's not much we have to do, so we're gonna still wait. I think you would be able to do this with climbing boots anyways. So our next one, before we have to stop by Bree just to make that one item, we're gonna actually stop by and go to the good news is after we go to the old and then that one character at night, it's just a rest of the time and it's all the carriers you can get at night. For this one. This is the last day carrier. So yeah, I'm gonna actually have to do that thing at the passage to the top, and then so yeah. So this is for the Black Gate, but so we do Nia May before we do the Otters. So the Otters are, so the total of 8. Because of all this stuff, we don't actually have to fuck with Karen. Technically, because we have all the tools, stuff, our certain names, Wizard, and you know what. Fine. So, there is a total of 3 more classes after this one. Also, learning is, actually, I do like how the items actually tell you what you need, what you can use it for. Trying to, like, hey, you have to use it, you can use it for this or whatever. So we're gonna do the Pass the Canyon and Ribbon now, and then yeah, there's really not much we have to do. Mario's gonna be done after. Oh yeah, let's also do Lord Ribbon while we're at it, so that way I don't have to walk back up and go here. So it'd be like, okay, so we'll start from the Black Gate and then we'll go end with the Mountain, because the Mountain is probably the easiest. But I'm also gonna show off minikits in a minute. Actually, I like how Claws got introduced into the game, where you can climb these walls, comparing to, like, you need to use climbing boots or whatever. So I assume they actually do it once a while like that, so that way the preloaded area is not, like, jacked up. Like how they had us walking, even though they could have had frostbite or something, because they had to climb, they walked across this mountain. And by the way, you know it's only a couple of feet down before somewhere warm. You know you could have just walked there. Okay, so we need to get his age at night. Like, it would have been nice if I only had to do one myth of wreck, but it'd be better if you could have got him all done. So you didn't even have to change at night once. So before I go to the main cavern, and then we're gonna do the myth of wrecks. We are actually going to plus if we were able to get to here kind of early, so it's the second age. The last four characters are unlocked in a certain way. So we're getting the next two by doing the bonus level, but before I do that, I'm gonna show you the mini kits very quick. Of course, we're going to show you from the left to right. Of course, this is Prologue, this is Sauron. The Dupree for Black Rider. The Nazgul for, Buttercup. Path of Canyon's the actual Path of Canyon, but with a little lightning. Mines of Moria is actually supposed to be the Bat-Log. Ivanhoe is whatever the structure was called. Buttercup was the tower where the Balrog fell, and then next was the marshes. It was Charmed Black Rider. Then it became Dragon Hobbits. That's Treebeard. Morgatak is the Orsimo of Rohan. Helm's Deep is actually a Ballista Turnit. Or Brother of Azia is of course Isengard. The Secret Staircase is actually the Palace of the Dead or whatever. To turn over that is Sherbert the Spider, then the Path of the Dead. Hey guys, welcome back to part 13, apparently, because, they cut off at the last minute, so, I really don't know what's going on with this, but, yeah, we're back. Okay, so, this part, we're gonna get the rest of the game done. Last part, I ended off with the minikit showing. before I just did that, so, brace in mind that that's what happened in that part. So,
that's what part 14 was.
It's going to be the rest of the game. I really don't know why that was, like, coming out. But, okay. Ignore that factor. Like, I feel like this is, like, the only Mithril brick I hate. It's because they literally have to flip the camera angle on you. Like, I'm trying to get the Mithril brick up there, and what they do is, like, I feel like this is, like, the worst one, because they end up flipping your camera angle, and you have to, like, not stay in a straight line, but you know what. But here's the thing, though. I'm trying to hit the where the crate is. That way I can, it could just be a straight line. I think this is, like, one of the worst,
Rex, give me a second. I got to really quick.
It's weird, it's something that's not right. Something.
I thought I just did something wrong.
I always get mad at this. It's like, I need to land where the crate is. Like, I'm just trying to figure out something. Like, something is not adding up. There. Now I can land there. And land in a perfect line. There we go. Now we have to do the bonus level. Okay, so,
we actually begin right here.
So, we'll lock at the end of this, no matter what case. Saron and, the mouth. So, So, we are going to be doing 100% the bonus level. Okay, so there we go. Trying to take him or something now. This bonus level, I think I'm gonna hurry up and finish the bonus level now and take care of that thing. And while I'm doing it still. But so yeah, one of the things I need to take care of doing right. Okay, so we are done in this corner over here, so we're going to be a mad sheep, and we're going to go leave this corner.
Okay, we're gonna go see the mines.
I like how they have the back end actually as the fore end. When this is actually the back end, I think, no, they have that right, because, yeah, but... So, this will lead us to, like, here, but Riven is over here. So here's Rivendell very quick. Actually, so funny is, this is actually, like, in the bonus level, there's actually the playable Lego sets. I did want to talk about a brief history. I do actually have one of the sets from Lego Lord of Rings. It's actually a piece of the Wall of Helm's Deep. Just a small piece. One of the actual buildings I wanted to get was actually Weathertop. Unfortunately, I didn't, so... Even though Weathertop wasn't as, like, big. So yeah, it's like I didn't destroy as much as I wanted. Like, once, there we go. This is it. So once you destroy them out, so we're actually back here. So we are actually going to continue our thing at the Black Gate. So this is like the low back end. Like, cool, it's 4, so it'd be like 4:30. I wanted this game done. I'm getting this game done. Anyways, I couldn't go to sleep until like... last night, I couldn't even go to sleep till like 12 or 11. I know, but comparing to like how I couldn't even go to bed 2 or 1, so that's better than nothing. So... fan tipped over. I didn't want to pay attention, so. Hey! Stay. Be good, fan. We're almost over. It's almost done. You can be a good fan. Be a good fan. Even though it's hot outside, it shouldn't even, like, it's not like a mucus outside. It's like the humidity coming in the house. I shouldn't be even wearing a black shirt. For a record, don't wear a black shirt if, it's hot outside. So yeah, I'm gonna have to flip back to climbing boots, but then, what I want to mention was, comparing to that, some stuff in the open world, but you can go localize that, so, like, what I mentioned with the Mythical Bread, that's how you're supposed to do it, you just break that, and that, so I assume they ran out of ideas. Bring in here like this, and then, so this is why, before we get on top of the volcano, I think I'm gonna end with the goat race. So it'd be perfect. Like, playing games, you choose what way you wanna end it. I might finish it all. That's basically what I'm saying. Okay, so we got 3, 4, 5, 18. So 18, yeah, that would be a good one. Well, that it's just downhill, I'm actually going to be doing that's the Mount Doom. This is the ice lolly, you need the ice lolly for. You know you can cool yourself off by just walking down this mountain. I shouldn't be wrong about the total because you need to think of... Like, so it's 126. And then I just need two more. Yeah, it's all 150. Like, it's not much to say. And always the thing I always hated about this was that, if I had to go over, like, my worst and best bricks from this game, this is, like, the worst mythical brick. I would actually have to say. Because the issue I have with this mythical brick is that once you fall, it's a long way down. Like... At least you can save yourself by doing that. Like, that's my issue with, I guess this puzzle with the Lord of the Rings. Until the fire passes by, and then... I do like that they put some points, like... okay, the player could just land on these and be fine, but it's like, that was the mental break. Like, you climb the whole Mount Doom. If I had to go over, like, the worst, like, I'm just gonna flip my character because I'm gonna end with Berserker. You do not have to end with Berserker. As a fun fact, the Berserker is actually the only one who can break metal in this whole entire game. And then you got, like, a couple character, like, when you hit, Lego, Hobbit, the only character that can break metal is actually Sarah, man. I don't know if in the, it does it in the one, Xbox One version slash S series, but, there's actually a glitch with, Saruman. You can actually get him early than you're intended to. You're supposed to get him inside level until you hit two levels before the, I mean, the, before you can get him before the last two levels are completed. But a glitch is that he would be there without him being marked. So yeah, that's kind of a nice glitch to talk about. But as a fun fact, this is actually the longest race inside the whole entire land of rings, but I forgot the whole land's name, so don't even judge me. By the way, when you do the puzzle, stud 2, and all your multipliers are turned off, so keep in mind that if you decide to do stuff differently, make sure you turn them back on if you choose to. And this is it. Brick number. Wait. So now that part is taken care of. Now we get the boring part. The boring part is going back to the blacksmith and sitting here while you cook them all up. Oh yeah, now I do it. They do attack you if you get the wrong one. Okay, I'm here with the blacksmith. We're gonna actually start with the back to the front. So this is gonna be like a good. I do want to bring some mention, like. So how would my list, like, go, like, okay, so, like, for my worst level would be, like, the marshes. Really, it's very hard for me to decide what is my best level. I want to say my best level was Mount Doom, or Mines of Moria, but I really can't determine my best level, so I'm just going to leave that open. But all I know is that marshes. It's because I blame the factor that the level's kind of slow, like you have to go from the swamp. But then also you have to also in Dead Marshes, you also have to go through it. I don't know if it's supposed to be like
know it's right, because you had 60 position for 32.
Yeah.
32.
Tomorrow I will for sure do a video explaining what I'm going to be doing this month. One thing in mind that I'm going to be doing in this month this next month coming up will be the stuff that was posted on the quiz thing. Because I think I'm going to be starting with one I'm going to mention about it. Surprisingly enough, I do want to say a fact, like, about it. I mean, we'll say it again in the video. I actually never started playing Madness Returns. This is what I'm just going to say here, because I'm doing it. I actually only started a little bit. I only still on Chapter 1. I finally made it. Wonderland. I'm first playing the game first to see if I might have this, like, you know, sensor. Like, don't have to do two versions. Like, the first game in the series, I don't. And the second game, I probably do. So I'm just gonna go mention that. Because now we finally made the last item. Once you get the last thing built, you'll lock the blacksmith. He's actually called Jimmy, and then get loots out the newborn. I don't believe you get loots out the newborn if you don't complete the game 100%. I mean, get everything done. So other than that, then this will lead to the game. So this is all for this time. If you enjoyed this one, I'll catch you later. But then, other than that, then hope you enjoyed. So see ya.